It's clear that neighborhoods living near huge polluters have even worse air quality than other communities. However, it's been more difficult to get a grasp on the effect of emissions from moving sources of contamination like cars and trucks. Mobile polluters are not managed or kept track of the exact same method as fixed centers like power plants. However, a current research study by the Union of Concerned Researchers has actually launched brand new information that measures the out-of-proportion effect of car contamination on specific Californians, consisting of numerous who do not own cars and trucks themselves. The Union of Concerned Researchers launched an analysis this month that revealed that Latinos, African Americans, Asian Americans, and low-income Californians are breathing in more contamination from car traffic than their more wealthy and white equivalents. Residents in the communities most affected have known for generations there was a disproportionate amount of air pollution in their neighborhoods, stated David Reichmuth, author of the brand new research study, in a news release. This modeling allows us to quantify the extent of the disparity across the state. Reichmuth took a look at great particle matter, PM2.5, concentrations from tailpipes and car refueling, and utilized a design to quote just how much contamination neighborhoods were exposed to by sensor system. There's even a clever map for parsing through the information. After integrating that information with market details, scientists discovered that black citizens dealt with the starkest variations. Both African Americans and Latinos, typically, were exposed to particle matter levels approximately 40% greater than white Californians. When it comes to earnings variation, the research study discovered that the lowest income homes, making less than $20,000 a year, typically, lived in locations where particle contamination was 25% greater than the state's wealthiest homes, making more than $200,000 a year. And those who were breathing in the most contamination from lorries appear to be those who contribute the least to the issue. The research study revealed that due to the fact that they tended to lie in metropolitan locations, homes without an individual car are exposed to great particle matter levels almost 20% greater than the state average. The irony should not be lost on local leaders and clean air advocates, stated Reichmuth. Great particle matter can have effects on lung and heart health. Reichmuth's research study likewise approximates that there are 3,100 sudden deaths annually in California from heart disease, cardiovascular disease, and other health problems connected to transport emissions. To fix up these injustices, the Union of Concerned Researchers advises the state take actions to shift to more fuel-efficient or electrical freight and traveler lorries. California is perhaps the state that highways made, so developing neighborhoods that make it much easier to walk, bike, or take public transit is crucial too. While Californians can make a difference by choosing cleaner vehicles, much of the pollution comes from sources outside an individual's direct control. The research study states, the state needs regulations, incentives, and other policies to reduce vehicle emissions. Equity and meaningful involvement of disadvantaged communities should be key considerations